Now the next topic in the bevel gear is formative number of teeth, okay, or equivalent spur gear. So bevel gear is kinematically equivalent to an imaginary spur gear in a plane perpendicular to the tooth at large end. So here if we see the figure, so you can see here at the large end of the tooth will be here. If suppose we are considering the pinion, the large end will be this one. So at the large end, the bevel gear is an equivalent to an imaginary spur gear, okay? Or you can see here the imaginary spur gear will be like this, okay? And here the pitch circle diameter of this imaginary spur gear will be back cone radius of the gear, okay? So if you are considering the gear, so at large end, now see here, this is the pitch circle diameter of this imaginary spur gear. It is nothing but the back cone radius of gear. So back cone radius of gear, and this is back cone radius of pinion. So bevel gear is a kinematically equivalent to an imaginary spur gear in a plane perpendicular to the tooth at the large end. Okay, so as we have seen in case of helical gear also, so helical gear is kinematically equivalent to an imaginary spur gear in a plane in normal plane. So similarly here in case of bevel gear also, the gear bevel gear will be kinematically equivalent to an imaginary spur gear in plane perpendicular to the tooth at large end. Okay, so the pitch circle radius of this spur gear is equal to back cone radius. Okay, so that we have seen back cone radius will be here back cone radius will be a to c, and the same back cone radius will be the pitch circle radius of this imaginary spur gear. The number of teeth on equivalent spur gear you can find from this. Now see here, the number of teeth we will find. So number of teeth on imaginary spur gear, or you can call it as virtual spur gear z dash. So z dash you can find from pitch circle diameter of equivalent spur gear divided by module of equivalent spur gear. Okay, so pitch circle diameter of equivalent spur gear d dash divided by module of equivalent spur gear, and then the module of equivalent spur gear will be same as module of bevel gear. Okay, so d dash divided by m. Now d dash is nothing but the diameter, and if you want to write diameter, so you can write here 2 times r radius, and r of what? R of back cone, okay, so rb divided by m, okay, because we have seen here 2 times rb. Okay, now if suppose you are considering pinion, so for pinion zp dash is equal to 2 times rbp divided by m will be same for gear and pinion. Okay, it will not change at all. Now RBP is nothing but, just we have seen in the previous video, RBP is nothing but DP divided by 2 times cos of gamma P. So we will write here 2 as it is. Now RBP is DP divided by 2 times cos of gamma P, yeah, into now this M as it is. So this 2 will get cancelled, and you can write here DP divided by cos of gamma p into m. Now dp by m is nothing but zp, okay, because m is nothing but d by z. Okay, so dp by m will be zp. So you can write here zp dash is equal to zp divided by cos of gamma p. Okay, so in this way you can find number of teeth on equivalent spur gear zp dash. Then similarly you can do this for gear also, and you will get zg dash is equal to zg divided by cos of gamma g. So by using these two formulas you can calculate number of teeth on equivalent spur gear and pinion, okay, where zp is nothing but number of teeth on bevel pinion, zg is nothing but number of teeth on bevel gear, okay, and zp dash is nothing but number of teeth on equivalent spur gear or virtual spur gear or imaginary spur gear, and zg imaginary spur pinion, sorry, pinion, and zg dash is nothing but नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन इमेजनरी स्पर गियर, ओके, और वर्चुअल स्पर गियर. सो नाउ मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन बेवल पिनियन वी विल सी इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो.